I haven't done extensive study or any real like, yeah, extensive study about it. I remember sitting, I believe it was for the brother who I mentioned, Joe Bradford, when we were in Medina. We were a couple of students, and someone brought up, and I wish I, you know, it was one of those, didn't bother to like research, what was known. One of the theories was that the Turks, before Islam, they worshipped like a cow god or something like that, where if you turn, you know, the crescent, right? Well, it's not really giving a C, right? But if you turn it upside down, it's like horns, or upside down, or you turn it upside right side up, right? It's like horns, and then it has like a star, and that's like either represents an eye or something to that effect. So all they did was switch it back, or kind of, you know, turn it into the crescent moon. And one of the reasons why it's represented that way, right, is because the Muslims, when it comes to, for example, following their holy months, or when we are looking for the month to begin, it doesn't start for us like the first of, you know, September or the first of October, and, you know, we just you know, start, look at the calendar that way. No, what Muslims, especially in the past up to now, what they do is they look at the new moon, and when they witness, right, the new moon, that is the actual first day of that month. So the moon is a representation of the starting of the new month every year, especially when it's extremely important for us when we start the month of Ramadan, or we're going into the holy month of it's called the Hijjah, which is the pilgrimage of, you know, when people make the pilgrimage to Mecca that month. So it's very important to sight the moon. And there's other reasonings behind it that have been said, but this is some of what I've heard. But someone has a more detailed reference, would love to hear about it.